racing car is a combination of art and engineering. The physics, the engineering tells you whether it will work or not. But it doesn't give the ideas, it doesn't give the inspiration. We've had an approach from Sony to say, would I design a car which didn't respect any regulations, whose pure purpose is to go as fast as possible. Because if we didn't have regulations, then the opportunity exists to make a car that would be really quite obscenely quick around the lap, but pretty uncomfortable to drive just because the G-forces would be so high.
リアルとまあバーチャルの接近というのはすでにもう起きていますね。フォーミュラ1のドライバーでも実際のレースの前にシミュレーターで訓練をしていて。
I came up with a specification for the car, did a few sketches as to how components could be packaged in the shape. Whatever we draw has to respect the laws of physics.
まず最初の質問から言うと、実際僕らも作ってみて驚いたのが、結構乗りやすい車なんですよね。史上最速だろうと思います。
Physically build the car that we're describing and get it to do a lap, I don't know what the budget would be for that. It would still be in the order of millions for sure.
Go back to the chaparral type solution.
The idea of a fan car was once banished and locked away, ironically because of its single-minded focus on pure speed. The cutting edge of today's technology merged with this forbidden concept. This is the X1.
Since PlayStation 1 and then PlayStation 2, PlayStation 3, all of them, I was a huge fan and enjoyed all of the games. Yeah, I mean, the car looks very cool, first of all, but it's very good to drive as well. The handling is fine, so it's just right, it's not out of balance. In other cars, you sometimes have the feeling, it's a bit lazy or it's too aggressive. You can't really put it on the track, but here the balance is just right. And as I said, the grip is a new dimension. So all of that makes it so enjoyable. Yeah, it was going too quick. I thought, we're talking about speeds around 400 and so on. But I went around the Nürburgring, I think, the first time, and I was, straight away 20 or 30 seconds quicker than I was in the real Formula One car. So it was quite a surprise how fast the car is. But you really need to get into it, how late you can brake and then still how fast you can go in the corners. And it's really a very tricky car to drive, but once you find out how it works, it's really a lot of fun.
Pandora's box has been opened. What you see before you is the fastest machine on land, the X1. its unleashed power will carve out a new legend on the circuit.
Very good.